Good evening, and welcome to the Las Vegas Times Weekly News. I'm your award-winning broadcast journalist, Frederick Shelton. This week in sporting news, Bruce Savage, CEO of the San Francisco 49ers, has announced that due to declining interest and ticket sales, the team will receive a complete overhaul. They'll get a new mascot, new uniforms, new everything. We'll now go to a promotional video released by Bruce Savage.
Hi, this is Bruce Savage. I'm the CEO of the San Francisco 49ers, and this computer simulation shows the new uniforms and logo, which I think are going to look fabulous! Okay, let's start. We've got a lovely fuchsia, and if you see the anchor there, that symbolizes the silly sailors, of course, and our boys are muscular and very, very sexy young men, and they're pink. Very, very tight pants with the white socks. I particularly like those. In the away games, of course, they'll have white pants, which are going to help to slim their waist and accent certain parts of their body. So we just think that this better captures the spirit of the San Francisco Bay Area and are certain that all of our fans are going to be very pleased with the new announcement.
Well, that was an interesting video, and we wish the 49ers the best in their upcoming season. In other sporting news, the virulent and unpredictable personalities of sports professionals. We're all familiar with the escapades of football players, hockey players, wrestlers, basketball players, both on and off the field. But what about tennis? We tend to set the bar a little higher for tennis, don't we? Of course, every older tennis player remembers bad boy John McEnroe from back in the day. And everyone recalls last year's 2009 U.S. Open, where Serena Williams lost it, had a meltdown, broke her racket, swore, threatened a line judge. Does it get any worse than this? Apparently, it does. Last week at the ATP Charleston Tour, Vera Zonareva completely melted down in front of friends, family, and cameras. A racket broken and kicked. Complete and utter shame. Yes, we're gonna love this video. Yes, there is nothing better than watching a hot young blonde in a miniskirt throw a temper tantrum in public, is there? But is it limited to just the gals? Apparently not. A hot young star from Ireland, Mr. Seamus O'Reilly, seems to have outdone John McEnroe, Serena Williams, and young Zonareva put together. His skills are enviable, but his temperament just may cost him his career. We'll show a few clips from Seamus.
Big shit! I'll tell you, you know what I think of you! Out? What do you mean, out? Out, you know what? You can do that with your out! How do you feel about that?
Seamus, do you think you have the mentality for tennis?
Well, a lot of people don't know this, but I'm actually a Buddhist. I'm just not very good at it. I admit being Irish or I've got a bit of a temper, but, you know, certainly no more than the other chaps in the tour.
Uh-huh. People have accused you of cheating. Is this true?
No, you know, I don't know why people say that, and it really pisses me off. Well, it's okay. I keep plenty of spares with me at all times, you know. You know, they think that this is for cheating or something, that I shine it in the opponent's eyes. It's not the case at all. I just like to look at my beautiful face and, you know, how wonderful I look after a match.
Uh-huh. And you've been accused of foul play. How do you respond to that?
I'll beat the shit out of anyone who wants to say that to my face. Matter of fact, I tried to beat the shit out of the last guy who tried to say it to my face. But he was a tough little son of a bitch. You know, he's only 5'5". But damn, he could throw a wallop. But I'll beat the shit out of anybody else who say that to my face.
Okay, Seamus, that's all we have for you today.
Thank you.
Well, he's a feisty young lad, isn't he? That's almost it, except for we have one unrelated story about tennis. It seems a group of sociologists have just determined that men who play neither tennis nor golf are twice as likely to watch women's tennis as they are women's golf. Why? Why could that be? Is it that tennis is more competitive? That it's interactive? Is it the faster paced action? I guess we'll have to wait on the study of those sociologists to find out. This is Frederick Shelton, your award-winning broadcast journalist, saying good evening.